Hi everyone, Kevandy here, and here's my review of The Dark Knight Rises, directed again by Christopher Nolan, starring again Christian Bale, Gary Oldman, Tom Hardy this time, Joseph Gordon-Levitt, Anne Hathaway, Marion Cotillard, Morgan Freeman, Michael Caine, Matthew Modine, and Alain About-Bol. A great cast, really is. And this time, we have this important flight of all of these dangerous criminals. You know, and the ringleader is found out, kind of like how Joker was found out, you know, in the last movie. Because, like, which one is he, right? They got these sacks over their heads, you know, and the ride over got them. So he's figured out to be the evil Bane. Oh, yeah, so we start out here. Well, like, how has the politics been in Gotham? The police system has gotten so much extra help from Commissioner Gordon, you know, everyone, after what happened last time, sadly. So, now Bane, he's here in Gotham, not a rude awakening in Gotham. Yeah, but that was so sad what he did to that main officer, you know, on the plane. Yeah, but that jump's too high. For you. I always say that. They're saying, like, for you. You know, so now we meet Bane. And back in Gotham, we're having this sad memorial. They're talking about Harvey. You know, it was so terrible that he became the villain and everything. Believe it. And here are some government officials. Gotham government officials, politicians. You know, discussing right around Commissioner Gordon. And there's this maid who seems very interested in where Bruce is. You know, what has Bruce been doing? Because, you know, after The Dark Knight, Bruce took a little hiatus, the smallest. And so she's looking around and she goes down towards this awesome target. You know, who shoots the target? The, you know, needing a little leg healing Bruce Wayne. Grew out his beard. Amazing. Because Bruce has been taking it easy after everything he had to deal with, you know, last time. And it's like, who are you? And then she tries to steal cat burglar she is. Yeah, so gotta go after her, of course. So Bruce, with the help of Alfred, find out who she is and everything. Well, in the meantime, we have Officer Blake, who's scouting all of these negative Gotham Street things. You know, added on by Bane, because Bane and his whole regime is trying to take Gotham back for the people. You gotta hear how he says it, for the people. They're trying to take it back, because it's mainly, you know, just Bruce becoming Batman again. Because I don't want to give away why, you know, but he's becoming Batman again. And there's this another criminal cartel in Gotham. There always is, right? You know, has to be stopped again. So Bruce, he does become Batman again. And Lucius Fox, he makes him some more awesome equipment that does come in black. Of course. Yeah, and Alfred is, you know, just wanting Bruce to be happier more than ever. Because, you know, he talks about how he wants, how, you know, he does. He does sit in a nice cafe in the center point of France. And one day, Master Wayne, I would like to see you. I gotta do it. One day, Master Wayne, I would like to see you across from me. It wouldn't be very far. So, now we know that maid is the cat burglar Catwoman. And she starts working with Bruce so that they can get Gotham back from evil Bane. Oh, and in the meantime, you know, he becomes acquainted with this really nice lady, an official. I'm having her name right here. And she finds out that she's related to somebody who's been integral from the very beginning. But of course, you find out. So now they're working together to stop Bane. Like, it really is, you know, like, kind of back and forth for this awesome finale. So, Bruce, he is Batman again, and his leg, he needed healing. His leg was broken, right? So, Lucius made this awesome mechanical leg brace, Mr. Wayne. Makes his leg strong again. And so, he's able to be Batman again. And now he has this new flying machine. I don't want to give it. It's so cool. But yes, it also comes in black. Yeah, so Batman's back. And he's getting help from his officer, Blake. Who we find out a little bit more about later on. He's cool. And it's, I think it was just a little nod. You know, part of his name is so iconic. It's all of us fans, right? So Gotham is having to guard itself even more because Commissioner Gordon is patrolling everywhere again. But he's getting faced with all these different dilemmas even more. Since, you know, Bane is trying to come in with these new politics. And he has, like, this giant press meeting. You know, and then Bruce calms, Batman does his thing. You know, and Catwoman is helping Batman. And is trying to get, you know, her cut of everything. She wants her cut of everything. But then Brain has this huge harebrained scheme in the Gotham Stadium. You know, because we find out who Bane really is. And it's a different origin than in the comics and everything. It's cool. And then we find out who Bruce's friend was. She is the Talia al Ghul. So what? Oh my god, she is related to Ra's. But of course, I won't say that much more. So they have to stop her and Bane, which they do. I don't want to give much away. But they beat Bane at his own game, I'm going to say that. And of course, they get her out of Gotham again. That's what her father tried to do. You know, and it was awesome because then Bruce is able to live a normal life. And let's just say Alfred had a nice trip to that cafe in France. It was an awesome conclusion to this super focus on what does it mean to be here. And focus on really police, you know, it's really focused on the whole trilogy's focus, especially Dark Knight and this one, are so focused on, you know, the justice system, police, everything. They really are, you know? And here's the hero that we deserve. Where is he? He's been here ever since 05. But I love how all of these movies, these two, focus so much on the on the policy, mainly the police system. Maybe not as much politics, not as much, of course. I can tell you, everyone, but like they focus so much, like, not just that, but like be a good businessman. Like it focuses on the morals. The first one, yeah, morals of being a businessman. Everything. So I love how we focus a lot more on how Bruce is becoming Batman again because he started being Batman, and I won't say why exactly. And how Bane, he's so mysterious, powerful. You gotta do it. Like it really is like a muffled Sir Connery. You know, R.I.P. sadly, but. It's so cool how he has all of this, the focus and just, you know, just full, you know, just amazingly, you know, threatening factor. While Catwoman gets all of her treasure, right, out of, you know, all of the perfect mansions. But how she works with Batman, works with Bruce. And they become good friends, is what I'm going to say. Especially if you know the comics and everything, they become good friends. And Selena and everything. So it was an awesome conclusion. It doesn't sound like a lot. Because, like, it really is mainly just Bane's trying to take Gotham for the people. Bruce is becoming Batman again. Meets Catwoman. And he's amazing. Like, he really does have amazing three mentors. I'm always thinking about these things, right? So it's always been Alfred, of course, for Master Wayne, for all that Wayne study. I gotta say it like that. And then, Commissioner Gordon, back when he was an officer, you know, looked after Bruce a little bit, and then he became commissioner. And now you have, you know, Mr. Fox, of course, all the technical side and the business side with Wayne Tech. So I love how he has these different mentors. And think about, like, they really do focus on different aspects of his life. It's so cool. And just how he, you know, rises to be Batman again because he stopped being Batman. And then, you know, Batman is kind of like thrown out of the equation. Like, what can we do? But Batman comes back. So it's awesome. So please check it out for yourself because I don't want to say too much. But I think I said good. So yeah, please let me know in the comment. What do you think about this whole trilogy? Like, yo, I loved how, yeah, they focus so much on what, for different aspects, what does it mean to be a great person? Not just a hero, but literally with being a businessman, politics, police, everything. I love this trilogy. And I love the specific, versions of the characters. I love them. Yeah, and how grounded. But there's a few things like horse scarecrow, you know, that's supernatural kind. And I love how he still pops up in all three movies. He still does, even though he's not scarecrow in this one. But like he still is in this movie. It's like rehabilitated. But he still is crooked in his viewpoint. So get out of here, Crane. You know, so it's really cool. Yeah, how they ended on such an amazing note. Especially for Bruce. You know what I mean? Exactly, you know. I love how they ended for Bruce, Alfred, everyone. Because he's been, think about it, he's been traumatized like almost his whole life after his parents died. And he was so young. So he finally gets this release of having to take care of Gotham and everything. So, I love, yeah, think about it. He's been having to like after all of his like preteen, like yeah, because he went when he was a teenager, you know, to Tibet and everything. So how he's gotten this burden off that's been on for most of his life, you know, like if you take off his childhood, like most of his life he's been Batman, or like either prepping to be Batman when he has the ski mask and then Batman. So I love bringing all these together. I have to. So I love how this is an amazing complete story of how this Batman, who is Batman, you know, has overcome, you know, the business responsibilities, have done a good job of keeping his business, family business. Because there's been so much, like, we can't keep this. And all the board members, you know, all those board scenes and everything. But he still has been able to keep the city and just keep him, you know, well, with Alfred. Especially when he's been able to keep himself, even though there's all this nonsense, you know, roaming the streets. But Alfred is so important, integral in that, and so is everyone. Like I told you, he got three mentors. It's amazing. Three different aspects of his life when you think about it. It's so cool. So please let me know, what is your favorite conclusion to an amazing trilogy? Is it such a great, it really is a perfect conclusion. And I understand, like, after The Dark Knight, what? This is a good conclusion, but I understand. But I'm like, and I love how Officer Blake, he comes around like, wow, he really is, like, this vigilante is still here, but, like, he is doing a good job, you know, he comes around to it, so, please let me know what you think, because I subscribe to the notification bell, and then all new videos come out, and these videos last Infinity.